Just that here. Welcome to Better Faith e-learning platform. My name is Mr. Benjamin Obi. Today is going to take basic science for basic 3 and primary, basic 4 and primary 4. And the topic is acid and base. What is an acid, or what did you understand by the term an acid? An acid is a chemical substance which, when dissolved in water, produces hydrogen ions. Acid can be found in natural products. Some of these natural products contain acid. We have food sauce like vinegar. Vinegar contains ethanoic acid. Grapes contain tartaric acid. Milk contains lactic acid. Lemon contains citric acid. Protein contains amino acid. Fat and oil contain fatty acid. And orange contains ascorbic acid. There are some of the acids that have been produced in the laboratory, and those acids that are produced in the laboratory are referred to as mineral acids. Some of the acids that have been produced in the laboratory, they are referred to as mineral acids. And what are the examples of these acids that have been produced in the laboratory? Examples of these acids that have been produced in the laboratory include, we have hydrochloric acid. Hydrochloric acid is a good example of mineral acid. And hydrochloric acid can be represented with the formula HCl. HCl is the chemical formula for hydrochloric acid. We also have tetraozosulfate-6 acid. Is also a good example of mineral acid because they have been produced in the laboratory. And what is the chemical formula of tetraozosulfate-6 acid? The chemical formula is H2SO4. Tetraozosulfate-6 acid is a good example of mineral acid. We also have triozonitrate-5 acid. Triozonitrate-5 acid is also a good example of mineral acid. How can you identify an acid? Properties of an acid. What are the characteristics of an acid? Or what are the properties of an acid? One, all acid has the following properties. That is, for you to be able to identify an acid, you must look at these properties very well. It will enable you to identify acid. Though this class is supposed to be a practical class, we are supposed to go to the laboratory for you to see most of these acids. One, concentrated acids are corrosive in nature. That is, concentrated acid can cause burn when it comes in contact with the skin. That is, they are corrosive in nature. What did I mean by the word corrosive? They eat away other materials. Dilute acid have sour taste. Diluted acid has sour taste. That is, it tastes like unripe fruit. For you to identify an acid, diluted acid has sour taste. That is, it tastes like unripe fruit. Acid, it also turns a blue litmus paper to red. Maybe we'll get to the laboratory. We use litmus paper to carry out the test of an acid. And what is litmus paper? Litmus paper is that type of paper that changes color according to the acidity solution that is dropped into, and so we can be used to test acidity. Let me take it again. Litmus paper is a type of paper that changes color according to the acidity of solution that is dipped into. That is, when we get in the laboratory, if we want to carry out a laboratory test of an acid, we can use a litmus paper, a blue litmus paper. Once you dip the blue litmus paper into an acid, it will turn that blue litmus paper to red. It shows test of an acid. An acid also reacts with a base to form salt and waters. So these are some of the properties of an acid. And what are the uses of acids? One, acid is used for making fertilizer. Most of these fertilizers, like the NPK, we use acid to produce most of these fertilizers. Secondly, acid can be used for making detergents like Omo. Most of our detergents that we use at home, they use acid in producing most of these detergents. Acid can also be used to produce drugs. Most of the pharmaceutical industries use acid to produce most of the drugs. Acid can also be used to produce glasses. Acid can also be used to produce glasses. Acid can also be used for petroleum refining. Acid can also be used for producing paints and explosives. Acid can be used as food preservatives. They can be used for making antiseptics or germicides. Acid can be used to produce germicides. Most of these chemicals we use in killing most of the germs can be produced using acid. Then we have base. Most of you might have been hearing the word base. What do you understand by the term base? A base is a chemical substance which reacts with acids to form salts. When a base reacts with an acid, it forms a salt. Examples of a base include sodium hydroxide. Sodium hydroxide is a good example of a base. What are the properties of a base? Or how, when once you get to the laboratory, how can you identify a base? One, it has a bitter taste. It has a bitter taste. A base has a bitter taste. Secondly, it turns a red litmus paper to blue. It turns a red litmus paper to blue. Thirdly, it has a soapy feel to hand when touched. That is, when you touch a base, it looks as if it has this soapy feel. Concentrated base is corrosive, that is, when it comes in contact with the skin, it can result in skin burn. Base combine or react with an acid to form salt and water. You might be asked, now, what is the difference between an acid and a base? You can use litmus paper to carry out a laboratory test. Remember, an acid turns blue litmus paper to red, while a base turns red litmus paper to blue. That is one of the major differences between an acid and a base. Another difference between an acid and a base is that an acid has a sour taste, while a base has a bitter taste. But I will advise you, it is not advisable for you to taste an acid, because concentrated acid, they are very corrosive and it can kill. So I will not advise you to taste acid. Uses of base. It is used for making paper. Bases are used in making papers. It can also be used for making soap and dyes. It can be used for petroleum refining. It can also be used for making cement. It can be used for making shaving creams. It can also be used for reducing soil acidity. That is, if you want to reduce the acidity of the soil, you can use what? A base. It can also be used for making bleach for domestic cleaning. Base can also be used for making baking powders and other preservatives. Most of these preservatives, you can also use base to produce most of these preservatives. So the essence of this topic is for you to be able to identify. You are expected to know the meaning of an acid, the properties of an acid, the uses of an acid, the meaning of base, the uses of base, and the properties of base. Practice exercise. What is an acid? you are expected to practice this exercise on your own. Give two examples of an acid. Mention four properties of an acid. What is a base? Mention four properties of a base. Please, I will encourage you to practice this exercise on your own. Thank you.